Should I clear cookies before I travel? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. In a recent video, I mentioned that I've got a trip upcoming, an international trip upcoming, and I detailed some of the steps I was taking to prepare myself, to protect myself from both data loss, from security issues, device loss, all that kind of stuff. After I recorded that video, I realized there was something else that I think is at least worth considering, and that is clearing your cookies before you hit the road. So why would that be something worth considering? Well, think about what it is that cookies do. One of the important things that we rely on cookies to do is to keep us logged in. Now, there's two forms of that, right? There's the remember me checkbox, which basically when you've logged into a site and you say remember me or remember me for 30 days or however it's termed, the idea is then that you won't have to log in again for that amount of time. That's saved in a cookie. Similarly, cookies are actually more fundamental than even that, because when you go from one page to another in a site you've logged into, even if it's your email like Gmail or Outlook.com or whatever it is you happen to use, then to avoid having to force you to sign in again for every single page, the fact that you've signed in successfully is kept in cookies. Well, that's convenient. Obviously, it makes the web tolerable. To be honest, I probably wouldn't be doing most of the things I do if I had to log in every time I went to a new page. But here's the risk. If you're traveling and your machine, your laptop, most commonly, is lost or stolen, and you've basically have all of these different sites in your browser remembered because either you signed in and you said remember me, or you didn't sign in, but it's close enough that you'll not have to sign in again when you fire up your browser, that means that somebody else who has access to your machine could almost immediately gain access to your accounts because they won't have to log in. Your browser will have remembered your login state for you. Now, granted, there is one big barrier in front of the thief, and that is that they probably can't sign into your machine. If you've put it in standby, hopefully it'll ask for a password when it comes back. If you're in hibernate, or if you actually shut it down or did a restart, you'll be asked to sign into Windows again. The issue there, of course, is that you'll have to provide a password or a PIN or something. The thief would have to get past that first. Probably won't, but they could. For example, let's say you used a really easy PIN and they just guessed it, or they happen to know your PIN from somewhere else. They can sign into your machine, and now all of a sudden they'd fire up a browser and find that you're already signed into your email, or you're already signed into your bank, or you're already signed into something else. The way to protect yourself from that is to sign out from all of these different sites. Well, that's a pain, because not only do you actually have to explicitly sign out from every site, you have to remember to sign out. You have to remember all of the accounts that you're signed in as, and then run around and sign out from them all. That's not practical. Instead, clearing cookies. Now, I'm going to go over four different ways that you might consider doing this. Because clearing cookies, once the cookies are gone, you're logged out. That's a side effect of clearing cookies. If you're logged into your email and you clear your cookies, you'll have to log in again. That's kind of what we want to protect ourselves while we're traveling. Technique number one is to use a third-party tool like CCleaner. As always, be careful when downloading third-party tools and make sure that they don't install something else that you don't necessarily want. CCleaner did this for a while. Sometimes they still do it. Just be careful. It's always been a case where you can opt out as long as you choose the custom or advanced path as you install the software and say, no, I don't want this additional thing. CCleaner is useful. I like it because It basically understands all the browsers that you happen to have installed on your machine and will clear the cookies on all of them once you say so. Here's a picture of it. You can see I've got listed Firefox and Thunderbird, which, by the way, your email can kind of be a browser-based situation where it too may seem to be logged in. In this case, I've also got Google Chrome on this machine. So you can see that CCleaner will, in one swoop, clear them all for me. Technique number two, and this works well if you only use one browser for everything, is to hit CTRL+SHIFT+DEL, which will bring up the Clear Browsing Data dialog box. There, make sure that you check cookies and other site data or whatever it happens to be termed in your browser. The idea here is that if you're only using that browser, then that's the only thing you really need to clear. You can clear the cache at the same time, and you can clear this other stuff at the same time, but the important thing here is to clear the cookies. Clearing cookies, technique number three. This one actually makes sense to turn on while you're traveling. After you've initially cleared cookies, as soon as you start using your computer again and you sign into your email or you sign into your bank or you sign into whatever, cookies start accumulating once again. Almost all of the browsers have an option where you can instruct the browser to clear all the cookies when you exit the browser. Sounds perfect for our scenario. The only thing you have to remember to do is at the end of the day or at the end of your session, close the browser. The browser will then automatically clear the cookies for you. That might be something you would turn on. This option would be turned on only while you're traveling, because it does mean that the next time you use your computer, you'll have to sign into everything again. Kind of sort of what you want while you're traveling. Perhaps not what you want at home, so you can turn this feature back off again. Exactly where you'll find it will vary depending on the browser you're using, but definitely look at the various cookie-related options and options related to what happens to cookies when you either exit the browser or close the last tab in the browser. And finally, option four, I kind of mentioned this one already. Log out. Log out of every site that you're using. It is the most annoying. It is the least invasive in that you're not going to be logging out of other things that really don't matter. You're not going to be clearing other cookies that may help you do other things. But it is something that you have to remember to do every single time, which is why I don't really consider it realistic or pragmatic. Bottom line, it's not a popular option because of the annoyance factor, having to log in again and again and again. And the risk, well, that has to be mitigated against what it is you're doing versus how secure your Windows login is versus where you happen to be traveling versus what kind of a target you might happen to be. But I wanted to bring this to your attention as something else to at least consider while you're on the road. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/148026. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.